What?
Legacy's been around since OPL was created, and they were dominant the entire year and completely ran over the competition.
Should I be adjusting my expectations for Mad Lions or maybe my expectations for Shadow?
I would expect better performances coming in.
Position because Shen is pushing top lane, but a TP.
Humanoid, I think. Yeah, there he is. Gonna look for the stun. There it is onto Isles. The heal is gonna get popped though.
Potentially, so now they see where the grave is at. Here we go. Looking for maybe the Alistar. Jin has flash though.
Yeah, Ray's gonna have to play this well, but Isles is gonna be the target. He's got no summoners except the Ignite and is gonna get aggressed on the Ignite. Is down. That's gonna be first blood over to Kazi. But now Shadow gonna get locked up here. So Vip's gonna try and trade it back. Here's the TP in from Legacy. It's Toppoon looking unstoppable. He pops the Bellow's Breath and there's the ulti out onto the Ezreal. He goes, he's gonna finish him off. Oh, he's lonesome. And there's the damage. Raze has it. There's the follow up as Tally's joined in as well. And Legacy punch back the two. Oh, it's a two for two trade. Never mind.
A single flash left on the side of LG. Of LGC, so we're gonna look at this play once again. Right, Alistar does a great job there blocking the hook there from the hitting the Jhin, knowing that he is not as important and as his AD, and then a nice little route with the TP. It is unfortunate for Legacy that this wave is so fat there. Otherwise, it would have been a lot easier for them to take out these members. Great combo from the Ornn and then the Galio to go top things off there. Just a little reckless there from the Ornn. Oh, you hate to see it.
It's going to be a 3v3, perhaps. Tally, oh, he's got Predator Boots. Quite spooky here is Galio. All in ulti, they're going to go for it. Oh, that's a kill. In they go. The sleep is there, but it's too late for Shadows. Babit finishes it off.
So she's dying right away and just getting that movement speed off. And another fight into the bottom lane.
Oh, Isles, what a flash. He's going for the play. Onto Kai3 goes, gets the restart there. It's in support or combat, but it's Isles that picks up the kill.
What an Alistar play. This is why they didn't go Leona. You can do Alistar and outplay your opponents here. Karzy can just walk out of this one. He'll be fine.
Not just individual leads here in the top lane, but trying to get vision and make it more here. Is Humanoid going to be the target of this mid lane gank? In goes Tally, but he's so low already, but here's the ulti out. Collateral damage is massive into the combo. Isles is going to get Humanoid asleep at the wheel, though, is Babip, and Shadow's going to get the trade, but it's going to be a second there for Legacy as Tapoon storms in.
Ornn is even further ahead. The lanes continue to do fine, and that means that you're not going to have the Shen ultimate for the setup around the dragon. It hits, though. They can sleep this Jhin.
Nope, no ulti, no luck, but Ray's still going to get locked up here. Here comes Kazi. Ray is dead to rights, but the trade kill maybe for Isles. Shadow is low, but low's not good enough. That's going to be a second. Is Mad Lions actually maybe going to save the day? Is Tally, but it's a 1v3 now for the Galio. He's got no flash. He gave up his life to save the Alistar.
And Shen is already rotating over. Both teams are very hell-bent on taking this dragon fight.
Yep, going to be almost all 10 in mid here. Isles going to be made drowsy. Kai's going to attempt it. It's a hex flash attempt though, so pretty low cost for him. Here's Tapoon, though. He's seen the angle. Oh my goodness, Isles! There's the Galio ulti down as well, but everyone's flashed out of there. And a great triple stun for Humanoid on the other side. But Kaiser now going to be the target. Another great taunt there for Tally. Legacy just need to find these few precious kills. But Babip is so low. Tapoon's going to be the ulti out of Cedar. And Humanoid again, a triple stun to turn it back around for Mad Lions as Tapoon is low, but will not fall.
And then Humanoid with two fantastic Scatter the Weeks here. This play's not over, though. Double teleports through. Okay, a party's happening.
They've seen one. Tally's gonna charge up the taunt, but he's gonna try and get a different target. Shadow's gonna be the one. Tally in, though. It's Raze that gets the dragon, and now he's gonna start shooting down the duo lane. Oh, he gets one in the air. Oh, Kai's the last bullet. It's not enough. It does hit him, but Orome.
Top lane. Here comes Tally in onto Orome. Babip here as well, ready to shoot him down. And Raze even in the area for a potential ulti, but
smokescreen gate.
Tower drop mid as well, so Legacy are going to get the tower. Queen's ulti cooling down, but not there just yet. Kai's with a decent little engage to start things off. But Legacy just going to eat the poke and walk away.
Onto Orome only, but they're going to keep fighting it out. The dragon, though, has been leeched by Legacy, and Shadow's ulti is back up.
after all the time that's passed. So he's trying to chuck Swirl Seeds in, but Legacy just want to finish this objective if they can. But there we go, Isles in again, gets the double knockup. Dragon goes over to Vivip, and there's the knockup follow-up there as the Alistar does get the knockup. But now the triple Drowsy there, what a sleep there for Shadow. Here comes the Orn, he does get it there onto Shadow as he is going to get killed with not being able to get Vivip or Tophoon. And now Ray's in there, but he face checks everyone and gets...
Know that he has, well, they know that he doesn't have Flash, and they're just going to flank him. Let's see if Alistar gets interrupted here. Tophoon's looking for the E.
Smoke screen down. Humano gonna get knocked up. Finds two actually. Tallying with a taunt. A massive taunt as well as Vivip's gonna get the shutdown. Here comes the Galio ulti on top of it as Razor's already taken down Shadow again. That Fawn is just so squishy.
They can go for Baron here. Let's see if Karzy can turn this around even with the taunt and the root. A TP is through. Look at Alistar looking for a flank.
Gonna look for it, gets a double knockup as well. The root from Jhin is good. They're gonna get the pick here. Karzy, he's gonna take down Isles, but Arome is trying to take down Razor. Damage is massive. The Baron with the assist as Arome is gonna prevent Legacy from taking the objective.
Certainly. Have to keep kiting here, looking for the Galio. They can put him to sleep.
Galio is Tally. Into stasis he goes. Babip to the rescue. Shadow gets out of there. And the Ocean Salt they weren't able to get thanks to Mad's great vision and team coordination. Ooh, Isles face checking. Pops the ulti, Humanoid's a target. He does have Flash though, and that's not recommended. Isles gonna have to Flash out himself.
Oh, then losing that Flash on Alistar is such a big deal. He's just gonna
dead.
Die.
Yeah, Kazi, really nice play.
Will they drop some vision over? They need vision. They hook the Ornn.
Tophoon does not eat the chat. There's Tally, find a three-man taunt. Damage is there, Humanoid gets destroyed. There's Legacy looking for the re-engage. Tophoon in onto Shadow as he's going to finish him off. There's Galio over the top as well. Shadow is dead and Reyes is going to kite it out and take down the Nautilus. Now Arome in a 1v4. He did it last time. Can he do it again? Trying to rescue the team, but he's going to get slapped down and shut down as Tally's going to take out the Shen.
Legacy turn the 4v5. Alistar not needed. Ooh.
Kazi is really, really scary and he's going to be put to rest finally. Dead. The final kill they needed. The shutdown for Tophoon.
Has now just turned completely there. Ornn, great stopwatch there, buys enough time. Did not think that the Galio was gonna come in from the backline. They were so tunneled on the Ornn that the teleport was so sneaky with the Predator boots as well, and then it was all too easy. That Syndra didn't even get to use her ultimate, and so now it's only the Ezreal left who is trying to do his darndest to win these fights, but some great flashes there out of Legacy.
So nicely as well, but it is the two solo laners that come up big there for Legacy. Tophoon and Tally find the angle to give them this Baron, and they're still going. Tally looking aggressive, finds a taunt onto Kaiser, pops the stone plate, gonna try and live, but Babip is over the top. He wants blood as Kazi cannot be caught, but here's Tophoon gonna try and find it, but he doesn't quite get it. Instead, the collateral damage is indeed gonna give Tally the kill onto the Ezreal. And Legacy looking to barrel down mid at this point.
Lilia just keeps getting caught. She is 1-6, and Legacy have no hesitation in picking on her. They have the Hex Flash from the Alistar getting real close.
Humanoid! That's not it. Here's the Jhin ulti. See you later. Syndra flashes out of the way. Last bullet. He jukes them all and he is going to live. Had the flash after all as Tophoon is going to tank up quite a lot, but they take down the tower. Still not done a Legacy. They're trying to finish off this inhibit. They will be able to do it. 35 seconds.
Lilia to check every single brush, but they don't have enough time. They don't know what Legacy is up to right now. The one control word will at least see the tanks. They don't know where Graves and Jhin are. As far as they know, they could be at the dragon. They see the fight.
Kaiser hit a trap. He doesn't have stone plate. He's gonna get blown up. It's Babip that gets it. Now Isles over the top finds Shadow. Gonna keep the jungler out of the equation. Arome also can't tank everything. Tophoon finds another ulti in onto Humanoid. And Humanoid this time absolutely has no flash as the collateral damage is gonna clip him. That's gonna be a kill for Tophoon as Kazi takes down Raze to try and keep Mad Lions in a Razor's face. Says it all in the player cam.
Legacy have got the objectives that they win, and Mad Lions had to come in here, right? You don't want to give up this Ocean Soul just yet, but Legacy was very ready, very prepared to re-engage, and they have just enough damage now to eliminate the tanks and then move on to the carries.
I mean, look at Kazi's 1v1 here. Very well played from this Ezreal.
The Alistar. Look at him. They don't know where he's at.
Watch Tally too. He's looking for a TP angle. Isles pops the ulti, looking for go in there. Here's Typhoon getting the ulti down, gets a good two-man knocker, but here's Tally back around the side. Humano's gonna have to get out of there. Tally can't quite get in as Isles is low, but he's not out just yet as Mad Lions trying to kill these tanks. But Tally kills Humano. It's Kazi now. He's a lockdown, but Tally once again finds the taunt. There's the double kill as Isles will finally fall. But Legacy is still trying to finish off the job as Kazi's being such a nuisance as Kaiser, his lane mate, will fall down.
I think that's it, Pastry. Mad Lions trying to cut the minion wave, but the Jhin is already topside. It looks like they might have actually stalled enough to stay in the game, but they will still lose an inhibitor.
Baboon is just going to try and make Kazi's life miserable here. Oh, Galio's getting in there.
Oh,
oh, see you later. Kazi does so much damage. And now they blow through the topside. The TP's in. Legacy know they can end the game right here and now. It's only Arome to defend with 15 seconds left on two teammates, and I don't think he can do it by himself. He's kept him in the game as best he can with the Shen plays, but Legacy are going to knock down yet another Nexus and push themselves to 2-1.
Tally was such a...
那赛后采访，我是于昭，我们邀请到的是 Babip 来接受我们的采访。那首先第一个问题呢，因为他们今天已经是拿到了2-1的一个比分了，所以他们是非常有可能会以二号种子，甚至也有可能会去尝试一下一号种子来进入到淘汰赛，甚至直接进入到小组赛当中。所以他觉得他们的队伍在整个小组当中的强势点会是在哪里呢？Congratulations first.
Thank you.
You guys are 2-1 now, and maybe you can just try to secure the second seed, maybe the first seed in your group. So what do you think of the strengths as a team?Your group?
I think that we're sitting quite comfortably right now in our group. So, I'm happy where we're sitting. I still feel like we're underdogs, but I'm happy about where we're seated right now.
其实说实话，我对于我们现在的整个一个排名还是比较的开心的，因为我觉得我们可能对于很多的队伍来说不是那么的被看好，但是我确实觉得我们能够到现在这样的一个地方，我还是比较开心的。那接下来下一个问题，其实很多的队伍呢在蓝色方的时候都会选择一选或者是优先级非常的高，选择莉莉亚这个英雄，但是他们今天用男枪来应对的非常的好，所以他是怎么想这样的一个打野的对位的呢？A lot of team prioritize Lydia on blue side in the benefit.But you cooperate with Graves very well today, so what's your thought on that?
I think that Lily is still a super, super strong pick in the meta right now, in the jungle meta. But I think picking just another high tempo jungler against it, it can like handle it. So an early Graves skirmishing early in the early game is one of, I guess, Lily's weaknesses. So around like the dragon, early Rift Trail fight, it's a strong pick, so yeah.
其实我觉得 Lydia 这个选择在整个版本当中其实是一个非常非常强烈的选择，但是如果说要去应对 Lydia 这样的英雄的话，我觉得像那种前期强势起节奏的英雄，比如说男枪，是非常好的一个应对 Lydia 前期比较弱的一个选择，因为男枪前期的团战能力非常的强，尤其是在争夺小龙以及峡谷先锋的时候是非常有优势的，所以我觉得这是比较好的应对方式。那最后一个问题，他们要即将上应对的是 Supermassive, 也是一个以打野为核心的战队，所以他会不会有一些担心呢？ You're going to play against Supermassive, which rely heavily on their jungler.
Yep.
Were you worried about that?
I think Kao is like really good. I think I can definitely handle him, and I'm excited to play.
我觉得卡靠是一个非常强的选手，但是我确实也觉得我还是有信心能够比较好的可能应对他，处理他的这一些表现的，我还是比较有信心对于我自己的一个表现。 OK, congratulations.
Thank you.
我们赛后采访呢到此就先告一段落了。